Children, look at the cross section of leaf in figure 6.1. So the figure 6.1 is showing you the leaf cross section. This is the leaf. The leaf cross section is being shown from this part. So if you cut the leaf in this way, then you'll be able to see this particular area. So that part is being shown there. You can see the upper epidermis, the lower epidermis, and then the cells in between. Check out those. I hope you'll be able to locate the air spaces, guard cells, and chloroplasts. You have two activities, 6.2 and 6.4. Sorry, 6.1 and 6.2 activities. These two activities are to prove the importance of chlorophyll and the importance of carbon dioxide during photosynthesis. Not only this, from the equation, you should be in the position to prove the importance of any of these reactants. So if carbon dioxide is not there, will there be photosynthesis? How will you prove? If chlorophyll is not there, will there be photosynthesis or not? How will you prove? If sunlight is not there or if water is not there, any of these conditions have to be proven experimentally. So what is the landmark event which confirms that photosynthesis has taken place? Which phenomena will tell us that yes, photosynthesis has occurred? Ultimately, glucose or starch should be formed. If starch is formed or if glucose is formed, then we say photosynthesis has taken place. If glucose is not formed, starch is not formed, then it is assumed that there is no photosynthesis which has taken place. So how will we know whether starch has been made by the plant or not? Whether starch is manufactured in the plant body or not? How will we know? This is a small activity which you have been doing from class 6. A simple iodine test or starch test. Just add few drops of iodine solution to the material. Is turning blue-black in color, it shows that starch is present. If it is not showing blue-black color, it says that starch is absent. So this step is, I hope, it's very clear to you. But here, we need to follow a procedural method. Because simply, you cannot pluck any leaf and put iodine solution and check. It's not possible. Because all the plants are already exposed to sunlight, carbon dioxide, water and all. And even if you simply put iodine solution upon the leaf which is having a tough cell wall, it's very difficult to get the iodine absorbed into the leaf and show you better results. So it requires some particular protocol. Let's see the protocol or the basic steps which will help us to, which will lead us more correctly, the so-called starch test. So, in the first case, 6.1 is discussing the activity to prove chlorophyll is important and 6.2 is discussing about the importance of carbon dioxide. But the steps are almost the same. Though we have taken a variegated leaf for chlorophyll test, whereas a normal plant, any potted plant can be taken for checking out the importance of carbon dioxide. Remember, a variegated leaf is such kind of leaf which is having some parts with chlorophyll and some parts without chlorophyll. So therefore, you should be getting iodine test positive, I mean blue-black color, only in those regions which are having green-colored patches. Those regions which are having white-colored or say any other color colored patches other than green should not be showing. So-called results, blue-black color might not be shown. Particularly if it is white, we call such kind of white and green. Such kind of leaves are said to be variegated. Because when it is having any other kind of pigment, it may be having a hidden chlorophyll beneath also. Still, photosynthesis is possible there. So the first step in any of these photosynthetic experiments, the first step is formed, that is destarching. Destarching means first of all remove all the starch from the plant body. How will you remove? Because if you just take any plant from outside, of course the entire plant body may be having starch. where the entire body will give you blue black color. So first of all, remove the starch from the leaves. How will you remove the starch from the leaves? That is, this process is called de-starch. This can be done by keeping the plant in dark room. Dark room for say 48 hours or 2 days. So plant to be kept in dark room. When there is no sunlight, there won't be any photosynthesis. So the plant will start utilizing already existing or already stored starch. Therefore, because it is utilizing its own starch, after 2 days or so, there won't be any starch. Or even if it is there, it could be very, very little. This step is very, very crucial. Because if this step is not followed, the results will be biased. The second step, expose to sunlight now. Exposed to sunlight for at least 2 to 4 hours, depending upon the intensity of the light and depending upon the kind of experiment. It can be 2 hours, it can be 4 hours, it can be 6 hours, depending upon the thickness of the leaf, intensity of sunlight, many factors are there. So if you are taking a variegated leaf, if you are taking a normal plant, the steps are common. So you will find similar steps in both 6.1 and 6.2 activity. Check out. So after exposing to sunlight, bring those leaves. It can be variegated leaves or it can be the leaves from the other experiment. So bring those leaves. The leaves have to be, first of all, dipped in boiling water for say 2 minutes, approximately 2 minutes. This step is very important because it will help us to make the leaves softer. The cell wall becomes soft, and now the leaves have also become almost dead because they are dipped in boiling water. So therefore, because once the leaf becomes soft, you start dissolving the chlorophyll. The alcohol is the next step very easily. It will also be able to absorb iodine very easily because it is now softer. The cell wall is already disrupted. So the next step is, after dipping